MTV, welcome to my crib.
There it is. Don't know if you can see, it might be a little blown out, but looks good. And you got people with tripods set up, so we know where we're gonna go.
Simply remember my favorite things, and then I don't feel so guys, we are up very early. The sun hasn't even come up yet. It's I think 6:30, almost 7 a.m. But we have a booked in time slot at the pool and spa today, which is really exciting. So the way a lot of hotels are working now because of everything going on is you have to pre-book a slot so that they can limit the amount of people in the pool, which is actually really smart and safe. And we wanted to go really, really early because we wanted to have it basically to ourselves. A lot of the times, yeah, it's very early, but a lot of the times with like what we do on Instagram, it kind of involves us having to wake up early because we beat the crowds, but we are really excited. I think we're going to just enjoy the pool and jacuzzi, and then we have the whole rest of the afternoon to just chill in our hotel room, which is like what we love to do.
Well, luckily this morning
get
it's like
breakfast.
Raining.
Yeah, it's a rainy day, so like we're gonna put the fireplace on and just chill, have a cozy afternoon until we have to check out. But yeah, that's our plan today. So we'll take you with us to the pool. All right, so you've made it to spa. Super nice. So this is the lavender sauna. We've got some steam rooms, which unfortunately are closed right now. There's another sauna. And the pool.
Ourselves, which is pretty cool.
Love you
too. There's an outdoor like sauna pool type thing, like a hot pool. Yeah, it's really nice. But at the moment it's raining like crazy. We have like an ice thing here, I guess if you really want to cool off. We have a sauna, but unfortunately that's not in use because obviously COVID. But yeah.
Good morning, everybody.
Good morning.
We just had the best morning. We went to the spa at Dormy House, which is so nice, which we showed you guys. We took you with us. And then what did we do, babe?
We just had breakfast, and then we packed, then we relaxed, laid around, had some coffee. Mm-hmm. Like the best morning you could ever want, really.
Yeah, honestly, basically, George and I were saying this whole time, this trip, we really wanted to just relax.
Yeah.
Have time in the hotel, kind of just stay in our PJs all day.
Yeah. Well, I think we were lucky as well, because like sometimes when you take pictures and you do work, like you either have good days or you have bad days. Mm-hmm. And if you have a good day, it means you can be done, finished, whatever. If you have a bad day, you have to keep going. And for us, like we just crushed the whole day. So good. And we were just like, okay, cool. Like we can totally relax.
Yeah. We just really had a really good afternoon and day.
Yeah.
So we're checking out, sadly. We had the best day ever.
Yeah, we'll be back.
We'll definitely be back. We loved it.
The place is amazing.
There was only 8 rooms, so during this time, that's like what we wanted. We didn't want somewhere too big or anything like that. But today, we're going to continue going to a few villages in the Cotswolds, so we'll take you around. And then we're checking into a little Airbnb, which is super cute.
Yeah, it's like its own little annex type thing.
Yeah.
And it's a little loft conversion. It's going to be cute.
Yeah.
So I just hope it's going to be warm.
I know.
Just crank
you and I will
heat.
Be just like cuddled under the blankets the whole time. But yeah, we'll take you with us today, and it's going to be a good afternoon.
Yeah, it's going to be fun. So see you then.
See you there.
So we made it to
Chipping Campden.
That's the one. Almost forgot.
Church.
Yeah, this town's really pretty. So yeah, let's go and explore.
We just like all the stone buildings because they're so beautiful.
Yeah, this stone is just like gold.
Typical Cotswolds.
Sheep. Stream.
One day,
yes.
That'll be us. How cute are they?
Yeah.
Me and you, yeah?
Cute. Yeah.
Well, we're old. Okay, so we just made it to this beautiful church in Chipping Campden, and there's this beautiful graveyard, which I don't know if you can say beautiful, but my stepmom Jen, she's obsessed with graveyards, so I feel like she would really like this. How cool is this?
Yeah, it's cool.
Anyways, my stepmom loves graveyards, so she would probably tell me to find the oldest tombstone, but some of these have like no words on them, so I'll show you what they look like, but there's no dates or anything like that. See? They're covered with like moss, but there's no real date or anything. This one's really creepy. But yeah, super pretty. We got super lucky today because it was supposed to rain. So luckily for us, no rain. Okay, so I just put on the Sound of Music soundtrack because I feel like that is just like the perfect music to listen to.
Sheep Street.
Sorry, Sanav. Just the perfect music to listen to on this car ride. It's just peaceful.
Wasn't the Sound of Music in Austria though?
It was, but I don't know. Cotswolds, Sound of Music? Good vibes. Anyways, I'll turn you guys around. We're leaving the town now. Say goodbye, Chipping Campden. It was really cute. It's just like one little basically walkway, which is really nice. And then now we're heading over to Burford.
So. Wild geese that fly with the moon on their wings. These are a few of my favorite things. Girls in white dresses with blue satin sashes. Snowflakes that stay on my nose and eyelashes. Silver white winters and melt into springs. These are a few of my favorite things. When the dog bites, when the bee stings, when I'm feeling sad, I simply remember my favorite things, and then I don't feel so bad.
So we just got to...
Burford. Burford?
Burford.
Burford.
Yeah.
I don't have the right accent, you guys. Sometimes when I say things in my American accent, it just sounds so wrong. Like,
you know, it sounds American, that's it. You know.
I know, but I hate the accent that I have because it just makes such quaint words sound just ratchet.
A little, yeah, vandalized.
Vandalized.
But yeah, so we walked around the other town. It was okay.
Yeah, it was super cute. It's just like one straight walk though, so
yeah.
You could easily see it in like 20 minutes.
And I feel like parking there was a nightmare. I mean, we were pretty lucky, but even still.
Yeah.
Yeah, had to parallel park and it was like a one-way street and...
George gets a little anxious when...
When I got Hannah yelling at me, people behind me bibbing.
You guys, I'm the biggest backseat driver ever.
It's the worst.
I admit it.
Yeah.
But that's because I'm just used to driving in LA.
And that idiot who almost like made us... Yeah, God damn it.
A fly just went in my mouth. Everyone in LA drives so aggressively, which is what I'm used to, so.
Yeah.
Here they like don't honk. If someone's in the way, they like just don't honk. I'm like, babe, honk the horn. Like, you can honk your horn, or we could just sit here for 15 minutes.
Yeah.
Oh, what's it called?
Yeah.
What's it called?
You tell me.
I forgot. It's not even on me, George.
Yeah, it is. What are you on about?
What's it called? Oh, the street. Oh, the street, because it's super cute.
Yeah, so we made it here, and this street is pretty. I think we're going to head in here.
Green tea.
Let's do it.
To the bakery. Oh, wait. Mask on. Okay, you guys, we just checked in to our little Airbnb.
We're here.
We already kind of unpacked and made a mess, but...
Yeah, we checked in a few hours
We're staying in this little, like, attic room. It's super cute, above a garage.
Yeah.
But it has everything we need. It has
I love it.
A nice bed, a little kitchenette, so we could have, like, tea and coffee. We got our wine there, bathroom there. But yeah, we like to mix it up between Airbnbs and... hotels. Anyways, we just got dressed. We're going out to dinner now. We're gonna have some pub food.
Yeah, it's gonna be good. I'm excited.
It's gonna be tasty, so we'll take you there. Comfortable, you guys. Very pleased about that. We last checked in with you after dinner last night. It was so good. So good. The Checkers is definitely, we highly recommend if you are in Cotswolds, you go eat there. It's just like the cutest pub and they have the best food. It was so nice.
It's just like really, really good, like, not like comfort food, but.
Yeah, but it was also just like, I just felt like it was like elevated pub food and the staff there was so nice too. So definitely recommend. But we got home and we honestly crashed out because we've had such a long day yesterday. And now we're gonna have some coffee.
How many animals did you see on the way home?
Yeah, we saw so many wildlife, like, driving home.
Luckily,
we
saw a badger.
We didn't hit any of
them. We saw a ferret, which almost ran over.
Wait, we almost hit a ferret, poor
guy. We saw a fox and a mouse.
A little mouse. I love animals. Anyways, we're just having a slow morning. I just made some coffee, I'm gonna go for that, and yeah, I just wanted to tell you about our evening because it was so nice. It was really good.
It was so much fun.
Yeah, just relaxing.
Yeah, we'd have to find more Checkers.
Yeah.
See if it's like the same, you know.
Definitely so good. Highly recommend. Ready for your coffee? We're just contemplating if we should cancel our dinner reservations tonight because
we have wine and cheese here.
Yeah, like we have wine and cheese. We bought a bunch of stuff from the market yesterday and it's like in the fridge here and it's just not gonna be eaten if we don't eat it since we're out during the day all day. And like, I don't know, like as much as we like fancy dinner here and there, it's just nice to kind of like chill out in our Airbnb and like have the night to ourselves. I think we're gonna
plus there's that smokery house down the road, so we should also pick up
another
little item from there.
Yeah, we want to get something for George's dad because he likes that stuff. So yeah, I think we should cancel. I mean, we had a fancy dinner last night, so I think one is enough on this trip and we can just enjoy the room.
Yeah.
Okay, phone them.
They're not open yet.
You've dropped the camera too many times. So we're here at Blenheim Castle.
Blenheim Palace.
Palace, right? I just corrected you on that and I just said.
Yeah.
But yeah, we're here. We're walking in. It's cold.
It's cold, but do you know what? It's sunny and there's no rain. So I'm super excited.
The weather's pretty sweet. So
yeah.
I think we lucked out because it's been meant to rain like the whole week. So let's
so
enjoy
check
it.
Check out this palace. Turn it around. Show them what it looks like.
Well, this is the entrance, so
ooh.
We're about to see what it's got to offer. And we'll record this time, because as much as we say we're going to show you, we don't.
We always forget, and we always forget to talk.
Yeah.
It's our downfall. That's okay, we're getting better at vlogging, guys. Come on. MTV, welcome to my crib.
There it is. Don't know if you can see, it might be a little blown out, but looks good. And you got people with tripods set up, so we know where we're going to go. We need to get a good picture of the palace.
So pretty.
Yeah, it looks great. But at the moment, we're walking across that bridge to get a cool picture of it all. So it's going to be good.
Yeah. Maybe.
Yeah, there's a few cars driving around, but
the only issue is light, because the light is above the castle. Alright guys, this is the back of the palace, and these are the gardens. They're super beautiful. Giant horse.
Yeah.
And a lake! Look at that. Stunning. Stunning, stunning, stunning. Here's my king. He's taking me to my castle. Look how pretty this is. Bubs, what do you think?
Ready, huh?
Ready to move in?
Yeah.
Alright, so these are the Italian gardens. Look at how beautiful they are. Everything's so manicured. Grass is perfectly cut. These places are so beautiful. Wow. Okay, we're a little close to the camera, but I forgot to bring the charger for the camera, and it just died after we were at the palace.
So. Well, luckily we have a charging cable like that long. So
it's connected, that's why it's so close. But we finished at the palace, it was super nice. Yeah. It started to rain.
I think we were so lucky as we queued up to go into the palace, and as we just got inside, it absolutely tipped down.
Yeah.
So all those poor people outside.
But it was really pretty, and definitely recommend a visit if you are in the area.
Yeah.
It's in Woodstock, so I always think of like the Woodstock Festival. We had lunch. We just finished lunch at the Stump.
Yeah.
So pizza good, place, you guys. And like, if you're ever craving pizza in the Cotswolds, definitely go there.
It's the cutest, like, so it's an old pub, but they renovated it inside, so it's all, like, nice and light, and then have all these, like, hot fireplaces. It's just, like, so good just to chill, eat pizza. It's
and really the pizza's nice. Just amazing. I'll insert a photo here. Anyways, so, yeah, we ate that, and then now we're going to a smokery.
Yeah.
And this wasn't even on our itinerary for this whole trip, but I had seen it on Instagram, actually, and George's dad is obsessed with, like, smoking meats
and fish.
Yeah,
he just got, like, a new smoker for his birthday in September, so he's learning that, and then...
Yeah, so as soon as I saw it, I just thought of him immediately, so we're just gonna walk in. I don't really know what to expect. If we find something good, we'll probably bring it home for Alan, George's dad, so that he can have it. It's kind of like a gift from our trip. We always like bringing home little gifts.
Trinkets.
I feel like when we have kids, we'll bring home, like, if we ever go without them on a trip.
Oh, they always come with us.
That's true.
Yeah.
Anyways, we're going to go check it out, and we'll check back in with you guys later.
Yeah.
Okay, that's the last of it, but... George and I set up a picnic and some wine outside. We watched the sunset. It was really pretty. Again, I'll have to insert a photo. Sorry, guys. I've been so bad at vlogging this trip. Basically, we've wanted to vlog this trip, but we've also just wanted this trip to kind of be like a relaxing time. So I have been forgetting to pick up the camera. Last we spoke to you is at the smokery. It was a restaurant and a shop, which seems like a lot of locals shopped at for like fresh meats and fish and cheese.
Yeah, it was good for like just a produce store.
Yeah, there was tons of vegetables.
But then they had next door to it was a different company called the Fire Pit, Upton Fire Pit or something. And that was like a big barbecue house like you see in America, like where it's a barn and all the tables and it's like, yeah, and it's the big smoker and all
so
that.
You could definitely go there for dinner or something like that.
That looked like fun.
It looked really nice.
Not for tonight.
But we had just eaten. So yeah, like I said, we just watched the sunset out there with our blankets. We We had a bottle of wine, if you can't tell.
Yeah, half of it's in the grass.
And so, yeah, we did cancel our dinner plans, and so now we're just going to pack up because we leave this Airbnb tomorrow, and we're going to watch a film, get cozy, and hang out, because...
That's what we deserve.
That sounds great.
What are you cooking, babe?
Show me what you got. We've got two different kinds of cheeses. Some really yummy olives. Leftover pizza. Prosciutto.
Prosciutto.
We got all the sweets over there for later. We're gonna watch a movie. And our wine. Obviously the best part.
Oh no, I'm gonna wash these ones.
Alright, this is our setup. Got our pizza, prosciutto, wine. I'm gonna set you guys here while we eat.
Dinner is served.
Hey, this is the perfect setup because you know what? We didn't want a fancy dinner. Just want to be in our PJs again.
Yeah.
It's that kind of trip, you guys.
I know. It's gonna be good.
I'm so excited.
What's happening?
Got some jelly beans, but you were filming the sky. Got some jelly beans.
Lemon sherbet. And a movie.
Mmm.